Hi everyone, this is Maria. So today I'm going to be taking you through the basics of run chart analysis. And run charts are a brilliant way of taking really dry, boring numerical data and giving it a really visual punch. So you can quickly and easily see if there are any non-random patterns to your data and help you with your improvement projects. I'm also quite hesitant to say analysis. The rules which I'm going to be going through are just rely on really intuitive visual cues, and it makes the process very easy and, dare I say it, maybe even a little bit fun. So let's focus in on my slides and I'll take you through it. So run charts are exactly what they say on the tin. They are a chart that is running through time. So you start off with an x-axis, which is always time, and the units can be anything you want. Seconds, hours, minutes, mornings, weeks, eons, whatever is important to you in your improvement project. And then you add to your y-axis the measure that you have chosen for your improvement project. For example, theatre start times, or percentage of a target achieved, patient satisfaction rates, any measure that you've chosen. So now you have your axes ready, so you can start plotting in your initial data. And you plot it in chronological order, and that's very important to help you make sense of the data. And you join the dots together. Once you have about 10 to 12 data points, you can then plot in the median value as a horizontal line across the chart. And this is a median line is what you are familiar with. You rank your data, and whatever the middle value is, that is your median line. And this line is going to help you see if there are any patterns in your data that are not random, to which you can attribute a cause. And this is the absolute key of run charts. They're about showing if there are any non-random patterns to your data. You might have done something to improve, or something has happened to your system that you might not know about. It's all about helping you see what's going on in the measure of interest. So you've plotted your median line, and then you carry on with your data collection, collecting more and more data. And the more data you collect, the more powerful your run chart becomes, because then you're more likely to start seeing patterns. And whenever you're making a change, make sure you annotate it on your run chart, so you can always look back on them, so you can see, oh, this is when we did this, this is when we did that, and so on. So annotations are really important to remind you of what's happened when. So here's my data, and it's looking pretty random. The data points are flicking back and forth across the median line. Now, it looks pretty random, but how do we know that for sure? So here are the four simple rules of run chart analysis. And again, I'm really hesitant to say analysis. It's very easy. You can visually see if something non-random is happening to your data. So I like a good acronym, I do. So I've made this one called STAR. So they're the four rules. The first three are very intuitive, and the last one needs a little bit more explaining, but again, it's quite straightforward. So let's start by looking at the first one, shift. A shift happens when you have too much data grouped above or below the median line. And I've demonstrated it here. The data looks pretty random, but how do you know if there is something significant going on? If you have 6 points sitting above or below your median line, that's highly unlikely to happen by random chance. Something is going on here. This is a non-random pattern. So this is a shift. 6 points above or 6 points below your median line. And this sometimes means that you might have to recalculate your median line. You've made a change and the normal variation of your process has shifted. So this is a shift, it's quite intuitive. The second rule is a trend. This is when your data points are consecutively going upwards or consecutively going downwards. It doesn't matter if they cross or don't cross the median line. This, again, is an indication of something not random going on. So here we can see a downward trend, and the magic number now is 5. If you have 5 data points consecutively going upwards or downwards, this is a trend, and it's a pattern of non-random variation. So for a shift, you need 6 points. For a trend, you just need 5 points. The third rule, the astronomical rule, is very straightforward. Here I have some random data. It looks pretty random, but if something suddenly visually appears out of place, this is an astronomical data point. So here, obviously, something has happened. It might be someone has inputted the data incorrectly, so it's always worth checking that the data is correct, or it means something very unusual has happened to your system that day, and again, it bears further investigating. Now, we're nearly there. The last rule is the least intuitive, but I'll try and explain it to you. This is when there are too few or too many runs in your data. A run is data points on one side of the median line. It might be just one data point, which is still one run, or it might be two together or three together. These are all runs. So here you can see in the beginning you have three runs, and these are followed by many runs, and you can see it can get quite tricky to count the number of runs. The easiest way to do this is to count how many times your line crosses the median line and subtract by one. And this tells you how many runs your data has. And when you've counted the number of runs, you look up the number of runs compared to the total data points you have on specific tables. And we have these on the PRISM website. And they will tell you if the number of runs you have is appropriate for the number of data points you have. This is a little bit confusing, so the way I like to explain it logically in my head is to think of a simple coin toss. So you're tossing your coin and it can either be heads or tails. And you expect a random pattern like this: heads, tails, tails, heads, heads, tails. It looks random. Every time you throw a few heads consecutively, that's a run, followed by a run of tails, followed by a run back to heads. Now, if you start tossing your coin and you get something like this: heads, 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 tails, 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 heads, 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 tails, tails, tails. You're still getting 50% of the time heads and 50% of the time tails, so it's probabilistically correct. But suddenly the data itself doesn't look random. There's something else going on here. It's a non-random pattern. There are too few runs in this data. And you can have the exact opposite. You start tossing your coin and you get this: heads, tails, heads, tails, heads, tails, heads, tails. Again, 50% of the time it's heads and 50% of the time tails. The probabilities match up. But again, this is a non-random pattern. There are too many runs in this data. So the easiest way to check for this rule is to count how many times your line crosses the midline, the median line, subtract by one, and look up the number on specific run tables, which we have online on the PRISM website. So in summary, those were the four rules: shift, trend, astronomical, and too few or too many runs. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do have a look at our other videos on the PQIP channel, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.